Okay, all right, I think we're working now. Okay, hi everyone. So I know it's been, oh wait, my hair's wrong. Let's get that right. No, not really quite. And moving forward. So I'm finally doing the season 2 finale. It's never taking so long. I got really wrapped up in Attack on Titan, then I got wrapped up in Hearthstone, then I got wrapped up in Game of Thrones, and then I got wrapped up in like life. Anyway, but thank you to Kelsey for telling me on Twitter to finally do this. So here I'm doing it. Oh, he's wondering, is my DNA in the background? It's kind of cool. You can get it done at dna11.com if you want to. They didn't pay me to say that, by the way. Okay, wait, is there anything else? So, not really. Working on making money? Working on that. Making money in San Francisco is more than doing the tech thing. There actually was a post about my science. I gave a talk over at University of Southern California. I can talk about that. I'll post that eventually. Let's see. Oh, in Hearthstone, I like playing the Shaman and the Mage, and I'm currently at rank 9. So, I don't know, not bad. But anyway, okay. So we're gonna go through this finale here. So let's like click on the button. Boop. And see what we got. Click the button. Okay. Now this isn't quite as bare bones as before, but you know, whatever. Okay, so moving forward, let's move the little things. So we got a bunch of pictures first, and then we're gonna go into the videos. So I'm just free response. Okay, so this annoyed me. What the fuck? This feet, no. In nerds, we do metric. It should be a 4 meter wide sphere, please. I had the same complaint with season 1. We don't use imperial units in the nerd kingdom. Moving forward. Another thing. Okay, people don't actually write it like this. They put it in terms of pi. So it'd be, 16 pi? Yeah, something like that. I mean, approximately. Actually, you could probably tell this, just depending on whether or not the numbers are divisible by 3. Yeah, that's actually kind of funny, because it shouldn't be A or D. I mean, A or B, because that's not divisible by 3. So, you know, assume they're round to the nearest whole number. So yeah, that's kind of funny. But anyway, so it should be what, 16 pi, or if it's 6, wait, that's it's 3. No, wait, no, it is 8 pi. Okay, so what's here? Kelsey. I wanted to mention Kelsey because she was nice to have back. She's so fashionably dressed, and her accent is so charming. Being raised in Alabama, I have an appreciation for that accent, and I wish we had seen more of her, but I don't know. So it is. I don't know what this thing is here. It looks like a little Cthulhu. Cool. So what's we got here? All right. So I saw this one. I saw this post on Reddit like a long time ago. And people wanted to know if this was like racist or demeaning or something like that. Because they said, I don't know. I'm just the editor. Okay, so my first thought was, oh yeah, I can kind of see that. But okay, but what if they had just said, you know, something in Chinese, and just like that's it, they hadn't left it? You know, I mean, that would have been considered offensive. And I think the question is, oh, well, you know, I don't know what, I'm just the editor. You know, and I don't know, I mean, it's meant to be funny. And it was funny, it was very funny. Like, you know, so I actually don't consider this to be offensive. I mean, it's not like they couldn't find someone that doesn't speak Chinese. I mean, come on, like, the production was in Los Angeles. There are people that speak Chinese everywhere. There's probably one, like, right down the hallway. But anyway, no, this was an intentional decision because it was meant to be funny. And you know what? It was funny. So that'd be even extra good. What if they were actually saying something in Chinese, I don't know what, I'm just the editor? That would have been awesome. Like, that would have been, like, so vicious. That'd be great. Okay, moving forward. Here's the crown thing. So, fun fact, I've actually worn that crown. Actually, about most people from season 1 have worn this crown. I don't know, most of them. Several people from season 1 have worn that crown. So the people in the intro sequence, we've all worn it. Because we got to wear it when Celeste was got struck by lightning or something. And, I don't know. It's pointy. It points into your head. It's pokey. But yeah, it's fun. Let's see. Oh, this puzzle looks brutal. I have no clue how you solve it. Like, most of the puzzles on the Nerd Eliminator, I had an idea how you would solve them. Or you saw it was, yeah, pretty good idea. But this one is just like, nah. That was hard. Okay, so I actually haven't looked at this one yet. So this was one of the puzzles on the Inert Eliminator. I didn't think it was that hard. So like, okay, so let's just kind of go through this one. So, okay, so in the movie Alien, well, it kind of gives it away. There's one alien. So that's one. Number other than zero, other than binary. Okay, one. Number episode in Star Wars New Hope, that's four. Mars, okay, that's easy. I haven't had a single one yet. Okay, G. I'm not so sure about G. I mean, I know it's at least two, you know, because there's Luke and Leia. So, I don't know, I guess two. Or at least, it's at least two. Yeah, it's definitely not one. Or zero. So that's the sixth sense. And the number of books in Harry Potter, well, that's seven, so that's negative one. And, let's see, Babylon, five. And number of feet, 72 inches, that's just six, because you divide by 12. So either way, you get negative one. Great, not too hard so far. Sides in an octagon, that's eight. Number of bits in a byte, that's eight. Number of laws in robotics, according to Asimov, number of Back to the Future movies. Okay, so I think the term is the three laws of robotics. I'm not exactly sure, but I know there's at least three of them. And number of Back to the Future movies, I also know it's at least three. So, and probably at maximum four. So three. So for R, it's either three or four, probably three. For G, I would guess two. And for the others, I know them cold. So I don't know. That's not too difficult. And you solve for N. Yeah, it doesn't seem so bad. Yeah, it doesn't seem so bad. And then you do some algebra and you get everything in terms of N. Yeah, it's not too bad. Okay, that's not too bad. Okay, so let's see what we got here. If you were with photosynthesis, you would... Oh, is this the video? Okay, it's the video. So here's the beginning of these. So let's just start playing.
Farting plants. Plant farts are essential for life. But did you know that they also produce water? They do.
I love that. So this is Brian channeling Virgil. I, throughout, as the show went on, I liked Brian more and more. His lines were just so good. Like, they were consistently good. And in this case, you know, so this reminds me of the Virgil line, how to go. Did you know in Hebrew they have a word for animals that have one testicle larger than the other? They do. You know, and it's like, oh, well, you know, this is very nice. Okay, next one.
You are all correct. Jack, you move into the winner's circle!
Yeah! Wow. I did not expect Jack to be well-rounded enough to best us in a trivia competition.
Good job, Jack.
Good job.
Good job.
Victory for Jack. Woohoo! That's my fencing stuff, so. Like in fencing, you're supposed to yell and sway the judges in a certain way to make it look like you were confident in your attack. And that's why I yell like that when I win games.
I love that. Okay, so things like you just like with the fencing thing. Like, Jack, that's exactly what King of the Nerds wants. Like, they want these little nerd tidbits from, like, you know, from, like, across the world, you know, that you can share with the broader audience. Jack, that was perfect. We want more of that. Yeah, that's exactly what King of the Nerds is looking for. Next. Okay, so these are two other things. So when Jack was answering questions, he did the hard ones. So at the beginning, he did the hard ones, and then towards the end, he did the easy ones. That's exactly the right way to go about it. Hands down, exactly how I would have done it. Like, perfect strategy. The Nerd Eliminator origin. Okay, so this is kind of fun. So for at the end of season one, the TBS team, I guess commissioned, I don't know, whatever, they asked a few of the people from season one to help design challenges for season two. And we gave them, like, you know, a list of options that we liked. I don't know if they actually used any of ours. I know they didn't use any of mine. They might have used one. I'm not sure. So, and I know one of the ones we came up with was the Nerd Eliminator thing. So we didn't call it the Nerd Eliminator, but we had this idea where, well, so clearly you got to have all the nerds to come back, but we don't want to do a voting thing, but we want the other nerds to somehow matter. So we're like, oh, okay, well, maybe there can be sort of maybe they can, like, pit their teams against each other. And then we're like, no, that's not really quite enough either, because, you know, you want them to be, you know, you want to be kind of a mano a mano, but the team sort of assist And, you know, we kind of had this idea where they have like a, they have sort of an Olympics of challenges, and they can like tap, and they can tap a one member of their team to help do one for them. And I don't know, they may have had this this idea before they talked to us, but I know this idea explicitly came from us, and so I don't know, maybe, I really like the Nerd Eliminator. I thought it was wonderful. I thought it was a good idea, and I thought it was well executed. I would like to think that we, the Season 1 nerds, had something to do with it. So, okay, next. What do we got here?
Yeah, congratulations.
You too.
Final two.
Give me a hug, you hobbit.
Oh.
I am a trivia nerd, and Kayla, Xander, and Jack put up some of the best trivia fighting I have ever seen. There are categories that I would have dominated in, history, poetry, but the way it stands, this is how it should be.
That was so dignified. I love Brian. Like, I love him more and more. Like, that's one of the most dignified losses I have maybe seen throughout the entire show. It was great. I remember there's some other really good dignified losses. Yeah, there were some other good ones, but that one was great. So dignified. Good show, Brian. All right, see what we got here.
She's like Midas touch attacker.
One, explain why they should be king of the nerds. The other one, not only explain why they should be king of the nerds, but why the other person shouldn't be. And I don't take kindly to people that say, in their defense, why someone shouldn't be. So my allegiance, hashtag Kayla.
What up?
Okay, I mean, I'll be blunt. I didn't get this. So I understand. Okay, so I understand I understand putting somebody else down is not the same as building yourself up. Yeah, you know, I get it. I'm just gonna be like having a video here, right? No, where's me? Here we go. Okay, so sorry, where's Alice? Oh, I lost. Okay, no, sorry. So I understand how pushing someone else down is not the same as building yourself up. But if there's only, like, really only two choices, like, a lot of people abuse this, and they pretend there's two choices when actually there's more than two. But in any case, if there's really only two, these two are equivalent. Like you only want to choose, you only want to choose the better, if there's only two choices, you only want to choose the better candidate. And it doesn't really matter. Like, I mean, you can both suck. Like, if you both completely suck, but A is better than B, you still choose A, even if A completely sucks. So you only have to show, so like when you're judging, yeah. So I don't know. I think Nicole was just, I mean, I don't get this. I mean, maybe Nicole Thor thought this was like, what, dirty politics? Something like that. But I don't know. I don't find it in any way offensive. And I think if there's two choices, it's completely reasonable. All right, moving forward. Nope. Oh, I messed it up. Oh, is it here? Here we go. Let's play this one. How do we do this? Here we go.
Whom have you pledged your allegiance?
This is Katie.
I pledge allegiance to the Kayla of the United States of Nerdvana and to the nerd public for which she stands, one nation, indivisible, with Star Wars and Star Trek for all.
Okay, so how have you caught that? Have you caught that you'd not say under God? I personally did. And I don't know, maybe it's my Southern upbringing. I thought that was interesting that she omitted it. I don't have that much of an opinion on it. I personally, if I were doing that, I probably would have said something like one nation under Turner Broadcasting Station, One Nation under Turner Broadcasting, something like that. I would have made it more of a joke, because you know she was like fitting in a bunch of other ones, maybe under science, maybe that. Well, anyway, I don't know. I just thought that was interesting. She made it on under God. If you're curious, the under God thing was actually only added. It was added in like the 40s or something. Actually, yeah, the original Pledge of Allegiance did not say under God. It was added like during like. This was added like in the 1900s. Well, I mean, like mid 1900s, and it was made to differentiate ourselves from the godless communists of the Soviet Union. Fun fact. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe she's just hitting it old school. So okay, hit next. Let's make this big again.
People, the odds of me making the final two are 18%. Currently, the odds of me winning the Nerd Eliminator.
Oh, well, I didn't get it right. Well, anyway, so he finishes it saying the odds of me winning the Nerd Eliminator is 100%. Okay, when I saw him, like, oh, Jack, you just lost. You totally just lost. Like, I mean, because, you know, this show loves doing things. Like, they love doing the switcheroos on you. So, I mean, I already know who wins. But, I mean, you know, if I was watching the show and I didn't know who won, then I'd be like, oh, I immediately know Jack lost. Like there's no way they would have shown that if Jack won. Like, there'd be, like, no way. It would have come off as, like, too easy. So... Oh, well, so now everyone knows that Jack lost after saying he had a 100% chance of winning. All right, what do you got next? Let's just hit the play without doing like this.
1 kappa 10, can you help me with a math problem?
Did Chris just say no?
She now doesn't know quite which way to go.
Okay, this was, wait, why didn't that work either? Well, all right, whatever, I don't care. So anyway, okay, so what happens there, so Chris says that he won't help her on a math problem, then Kayla kind of moves the thing around, and then she asks, can you help me on the cipher? And then Chris is like, yeah, cipher. And she asks him help on the cipher, and he comes and helps on the cipher. I loved it. I completely loved it. Like, Chris is so fucking strategic. I just, like, Chris is great. Like, Chris has a very calculating mind, and I really like it. It's good. It's good. I mean, if you're fighting Chris, like, in a game of wits, like, yeah, you gotta be careful with this guy. Like, this guy thinks a lot. So, anyway, but no, I really liked it. I thought it was very calculating and very, very strategic. It was great. So, okay, so let's go to the last little group here. Okay, actually, I want to fix that. Can I fix that? No. Oh, that's a little better. Okay, cool. All right, so we're going to go to the next one here. So here's with Kayla being crowned, and here's her little final monologue. I guess we're going to... Here, let's make this big for this one.
You. Every experience is a form of exploration, and every time you explore, you discover. One day, maybe you will go to Mars, or maybe you will cure cancer. That's what nerds are here on this earth to do. To do the things that are too epic for everyone else to do.
This was really nice. I really liked that. And, I mean, I don't know. I thought it was really... I mean, so Kayla didn't... I mean, so... And previously in this thing, I didn't really have very many, like, juicy Kayla quotes. And I was wondering... I don't know. Can we... yeah, but that was really good at the end. I mean, if she has quotes like that, I wonder why she didn't show her for other ones. I don't know. Maybe... I mean, I don't know. Whatever. So, but I thought for comparison, we'd put it against the final quote that Ivan had for season one. So, for your pleasure, I re-downloaded season one, and we're going to show it. I actually haven't seen this quote in a really long time. I actually don't remember what it says. So, but I cut it, and here we go.
If you go out there in the world, and you feel like no one appreciates you because of something that you love, just keep looking, because there are people out there who love what you love. And who will appreciate you for who you are. Being a nerd is about being special. It's about being different. But most importantly, it's about embracing that and making wonderful things happen for yourself. So go out there and be the best damn nerd that you can be.
Okay, here we go. I don't know. So here's the... I don't know. That's the end. So why is this thing so silly? So I don't know. I mean, I really thought the final monologue really hit the show really well. Like, it tried to encapsulate, like, the message of the show. And so we have season one, which was from Ivan, and Ivan says, "Self-acceptance and be the best nerd you can be, and people love you. People love you, and they love who you are and your nerd identity," something like that. And season two from Kayla, her monologue says, "Only nerds can do things that are so epic. Only nerds can do them, like curing cancer or going to Mars." Okay. I agree. I agree to both. I don't know. No, I like them better. They're different. I mean, I like both. I thought both of them were moving when I heard them. Like, I remember when I heard the Ivan one, I was moved by it. And when I heard the Kayla one, I was moved by it. What to say? Maybe it's meant to... So I can think of the season one. It was maybe more emphasized more a Celeste sort of arc of, like, self-acceptance and that kind of thing. And that was, like, a very, you know, big thing. And for Kayla... So let's see. So her thing... was doing great things. I'm not sure exactly how that fit her arc. I mean, don't get me wrong. I mean, she did very well. She totally won hands down. But I don't know. I don't know if her monologue really was in the show itself. What are you moving for? I don't know. I liked it. I still liked it. I do like the Kayla's thing. I do like ones that focus on doing. I don't know. I mean, maybe it's the conservative in me or something. I don't know. I really like, I like kind of Chris's view where Chris and Jack, and I guess Kayla as well, they're both like, oh, nerds do things. Like, it's about, like, very, very particular things that you do. Not quite achievements, but, like, you know, it's, I mean, if you just sat on your, like, you could not, regardless of your identity, if you sat still, if you didn't do something in the world, you weren't somehow active in your environment, you don't qualify as it. But anyway, I don't know. I like both of them. At the very end, I did find. So you saw this clip. You saw this picture very briefly. I found this picture on on Kelsey's Facebook, and I thought it was really funny. So here we go. Ready? There we go. Kelsey and Jack, forever. I'm sure there's going to be some really good adult fan fiction of that. Or if not, there will now. So, okay, I don't know what else really to say. I think that's it. I don't know. Season 3, King of the Nerds, is currently casting. As far as I know, it has not been approved yet. So, I don't know, we'll see. Let's hope. I've asked if they're interested in doing a King of the Nerds All-Star, so they can do, like, you know, like, season 1 versus season 2. Season 1 would win, by the way. He'd crush them. That'd be interesting, but they said no, but they like the idea for, like, a season 4 or something like that. I'm like, well, you know, I hope we get approved for that. So I probably will not be in season 3, at least maybe just a cameo or something. I'd be delighted to be a cameo. I mean, I could judge for the science competition or something. And, let's see, also, I don't know, we'll see how it goes. I mean, there are some friends of mine, applying to season 3. So some of my friends from Caltech are applying. And, one of my friends I live in a big hacker house in San Francisco now. And, one of them is applying. So, you know, maybe he'll get accepted. And let's see, is there anything else really cool happening? I guess that's it for now. I don't know. King of the Nerds is a wonderful show. I don't know, I still enjoy it. I still watch it. I still recommend other people to watch it. And I don't know, I hope it continues. I don't know. Nerd pride. But shocker. Peace.